right, welcome back, you guys. We're here, we're playing some of our videos and discussing, you know, all the behind-the-scenes things that you wouldn't normally know about. But we do, because we were there. Yeah, so. Up next is Pretty Fly for a White Guy. It's one of my favorite videos that we've ever done.
The kid in this, the pretty fly kid, his name is Guy Cohen, and yeah. We cast a bunch of guys, or had a bunch of casting tapes and looking through guys, and none of them were quite right. It was just a little bit too obnoxious or too buff or something like that, but Guy Cohen was the last guy on the last day, and he was just perfect because he's just so wrong.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, cinco, seis.
You know it's kind of hard just to get along today. Our subject isn't cool, but he fakes it anyway. He may not have a clue and he may not have style, but everything he lacks, well, he makes up in denial. So don't deep fake, play us great. You know he really doesn't get it anyway.
The guy in... portrayed by Guy Cohen in this video is, you know, middle-class suburban kid who thinks he's all hip-hop and down with the more urban culture, but he's never lived it, you know. He just throws on all the clothes and starts trying to affect the speech, but he hasn't really lived it yet, you know, and chances are that before this guy ever gets it down, he's going to move on to whatever's next. So we're just kind of making fun of the wannabe kind of thing.
It was
actually.
Yeah, you could tell
that
was going down. That it was turning out good.
Twice the good to kick his lily out. So TZ play us right. You know it really doesn't get it anyway. Gotta play the field, keep it real. For you know ain't, for you know ain't. Come on, you know free. Just overcompensate. At least you know you can always go on making it.
That was just kind of a thing that was kind of happening. At the time, I was really just driving down the street where I live in Huntington Beach and just saw a bunch of people kind of dressed like that, and the line just kind of hit me. I'm pretty fly for a white guy, and just kind of ran with it. Just one of those things. I was surprised no one had done a song about it yet.
Cuatro, cinco, cinco, seis.
So don't debate, play us right. You know he really doesn't get it anyway. Gotta play the field, keep it real. For you know ain't, for you know ain't. So if you know right, just overcompensate. At least you know you can always go on regulate. The world needs wannabes, ah. The world loves a wannabe summer.
He's an artist, one of my favorite videos.
I like this one a lot too. I really like this song. This is one of my favorite songs that we've ever done. There's a lot going on in this video, and if you'll blink, you'll miss a lot of things. There's one part where you come out of some girl's ass, or she comes out of your ass, or something. I don't really remember. You'll see it coming up. It's like in the last third or quarter. I mean, it's right here. Oh, that guy comes out of it. It's not you. The treatments, though, always match up with what you have at the end.
They can be very different.
Yeah. You know, you know, a lot of times you're changing stuff, you know, when you're discussing before you even start shooting, you're changing ideas with the director and stuff. And then when you get on set, you're changing things even more. I mean, there was, you know, I don't remember with this one, I don't know how much, I'm sure there a lot of changed in the editing. You know, he shot all this kind of with the idea of how it was going to work. And then I'm sure some performers just kind of leapt out more than others. So, like, I think that girl gets a lot of airtime. Pretty good, so she got more time than other people, you know. I actually ran into her in an airport. She was on her way. She was going out to dance with, she was with Ricky Martin.
I was actually driving through our old neighborhood. We all grew up in the same neighborhood, just about a mile from each other. And I was thinking about people that had lived there and grown up in the different houses as I was driving through the neighborhood, and remember that a lot of them had not such great lives after they grew up. And there was a guy that was killed in a motorcycle accident, a guy that kind of just went nuts. Really terrible, awful stuff. And we didn't live in like a bad neighborhood. It was a very normal, middle class, average neighborhood. And those kinds of things inspired me to write that song.